So when I was in 10th grade, I decided to enroll in an intro to computer science class. I go to the first class and I don't know anything, and I take notes and I think that I'm participating. And after the class was over, the teacher came up to me and said, "Oh, have you ever taken any computer science classes?" And I was like, "No, this is an introductory class. Like, that's why I'm here." He had never talked to me. He didn't know me. And the next thing out of his mouth was, "Well, I think this class might be a little hard for you, and maybe you should take something else." And I was like a very naive, trusting 10th grader. So I was like, okay. And I dropped the class. And I think back now on that experience that I didn't question this teacher. I didn't trust myself to be like, no, I'm really smart and I can do this. Like, what did he know? If I could go back to that time, I would be like, I'm gonna take this class and I'm gonna get an A just to spite you. So frequently, people who show an interest in these subjects really early get deflected by like a well-meaning teacher or some authority figure, and they end up doing something else that they don't love. And when that happens, it's really heartbreaking because someone gets diverted from the path that they were on, doing a subject that they loved, and end up somewhere else. And there's so many people that I talk to when I go out in the world who tell me like, oh, I loved space. And I ask them like, well, why aren't you doing it? Why are you doing this? They always have a different version of the same story, where they say, oh, this teacher told me that I shouldn't do it and I listened to them. Or this professor told me I wasn't good enough. Someone that tells you, oh, you're not enough about anything, about you're not smart enough, you're not good enough. That person is always wrong and you don't have to listen to them. In all of this, it's really important to know what you truly want. And this is gonna sound kind of cheesy, but I think you have to decide like what is in your heart of hearts when you're being like perfectly honest and vulnerable. One other way to think about it is like if I told you that you could never fail, that everything that you touched would go perfectly, it would all turn to gold. Like what would be the path that you would take? Doing the thing that you love, doing STEM, if that's what you love, is always possible. There's no one right way to get there. There's no one true path, but if you deviate from it, you can never go back. There are so many ways for you to become a STEM professional. You can look at someone like me, I'm an astrophysics professor, and you might think, oh, well, she must have known that she loved space, and then she like took all these classes, and then she went to grad school. But actually, that's not true. So I went to college, and I dropped out the Monday after Thanksgiving of my first semester. And it took me a while to figure out, like, what I wanted to do, how I wanted to be out in the world. And when I went back to college, I knew that I was taking classes because I loved them. I was like making decisions because it was what I wanted to do, not what someone else told me that I should be doing. And after college, I actually worked as a chef for a year. I went to cooking school and worked in a restaurant in New Jersey because I wanted to make sure that if I went to grad school, it was like really something that I wanted. I know a lot of people that have taken many different paths to becoming a STEM professional. I work with faculty members who were previously in the military. I've worked with people who were accountants in a previous life. I have even worked with someone who was a Rockette before she decided to go back to college. And all of those people, all of their different life experiences, they provide these really valuable perspectives when we're working together as a team. And that different perspective actually makes the teams stronger, we're able to solve problems faster and better, and we end up with better results at the end. So if a STEM career is interesting to you, it is always open to you. And there is nothing that can stop you except yourself.